You can probably see where let and const are going to be useful, where you need to scope something to a block or when you want to make a variable that cannot be changed by anyone by accident or on purpose. But let's take a look at a couple more examples of when we might be useful. And the first one is replacing the iffy. So I'm not sure if you've ever heard of this before, but it was coined by Ben Ullman back in 2010. It's called the immediately invoked function expression. And what it does is it is a function that runs itself immediately, and it sort of creates a scope where nothing is going to leak into the parent scope. And in our case, nothing is going to leak into the global scope of the window. So if I have a variable, just a var variable, name equals Wes, and I give it a refresh, and now I type in name, it works, and that's okay for the demo here. But what you might not know is that the window actually has a name attribute, which is needed when you have a window opening up a second window. That's something that maybe some third-party JavaScript relies on in order for it to run. Or maybe someone else has a variable name and you accidentally overwrite that, and it starts to get a little bit messy. So the way that they fix that is you make this thing called an iffy, which is a function that runs immediately, and you put your variables inside of that. Now, these variables are now scoped to this function here, because a function var variables are function scoped and they are not available in the global scope. So I type name there, and it's actually not undefined, it's just blank, because that is a property that lives on the window natively in JavaScript. So if I needed to access this, obviously I'd have to do a console log inside of here. But the important thing is that it's no longer leaking into the global scope. Now with let and const variables, we don't even need a function for our variables to be scoped to that, because why? Let and const are block scope. So really all you need to do, if we bring this up here and let's make that a const variable, make sure that it's gonna give us this global scope again, type name, there we go, we got Wes. But if I were to simply just open and close a pair of curly brackets, that is a block. And now it is going to be scoped to that block. Refresh this, type in name, you get the bare quotes again. But if I were to console log name inside of this, it gives me Wes. Pretty cool. You don't need any of that iffy stuff anymore if you're using let and const, because they are going to be scoped to that block. Another problem that using let and const will fix is with our for loops. Now, this is something that you probably have all run into with your regular for loop. Now, I just go ahead and console log I, and we should see that we get 0 through 9. Now, problems that arise here are two things. First of all, if I type I into the console, you'll see that it is 10. So we have this like global variable that has leaked out and is leaked into either the window or into our parent scope, which is not something we necessarily want. That's just a placeholder value that we need to work inside of this loop. And then second of all is, let's say you were doing it something inside of this loop. So maybe you had something that's gonna run after some bit of time, the Ajax request, or I'm gonna mock it up with a set timeout. So we'll say set timeout. We have a function here, and that function is going to run after 1 second. So after 1 second, let's do console.log. The number is, we'll put the I variable inside of there. So it's going to run after a second. That's weird. After a second, all of them are 10. And the reason that we have that is because right here, console log I, that will run immediately and reference whatever I is. So that runs immediately, it console logs itself. However, after 1 second, this entire loop has already gone through every iteration that it needs to. And the variable I here is being overwritten every single time. And then the problem with that is that by the time the first set timeout runs, the I variable is already at 10, and we don't have any way to reference it. Similarly, if you had like an Ajax request where you were looping through them, there's no real good way other than using an iffy to reference what that I variable was at the time of running, not at the current time. So one quick way we can fix that is if we just change var to let. And what do we know about let? Well, let is block scoped. Look at this. This is a block scope. So our variables are now going to be scoped to here. If I rerun this, there we go. After a second, 0 through 9, we're not getting 10 times. We're getting it as it was declared each and every time. You can't use a const for that because it will overwrite itself. You can't assign the same variable twice. But when we use let, it's going to scope that I variable right to our curly brackets here.